मैसेज डॉक्टर अनीता, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू वन मेथड ऑफ न्यूमेरिकल मेथड यूनिट वन। सो फार यू हैव लर्न इन योर स्कूल्स हाउ टू फाइंड आउट द रूट ऑफ ए अल्जेब्रिक इक्वेशन। जनरली यू हैव लर्न आज क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन एंड हाउ टू फाइंड आउट द रूट्स ऑफ क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन। यू मे फाइंड दैट इज रियल रूट्स और इमेजिनरी रूट्स। सो हाउ टू फाइंड आउट the general formula for the quadratic equation, you know, if the function is ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, then the root value will be x, that will be minus b plus minus root over d divided by 2a. So if the value of the function is given, then you can also find out the roots of the formula, like you can find out the real roots as well as complex roots after applying the formula. But here in your fifth semester BCA, numerical method gives you the formulas to find the root of the polynomials. Any polynomial, the polynomial may be linear, may be trigonometric function, may be logarithmic function, may be exponential function. You can find out the roots by using the formulas. One is your bisection method, other one is regular Falsi method, and that is your, this is your Newton-Raphson method. I think you might have come across your, might have seen the videos of bisection method, how to apply the formula and how many iterations it runs. And after that, so many iterations, you find the approximate value of the function. It's quite lengthy method. Then you know about regular Falsi method. And this is also a very fantastic method. It gives some little bit relief as compared to bisection method. And bisection means divide by two. So when two roots you assume, provided the conditions are fa into fb less than zero, that means if fa is positive, fb is negative. If fa is negative, fb is positive. So both are of opposite sign. And fa into fb less than 0, this condition must be satisfied in bisection as well as regular Falsi method. So bisection method, how to find out the roots? Sum of the roots divided by 2. Sum of two roots divided by 2. Then you apply to function and condition must be satisfied, then you go ahead. Regular Falsi method, the same conditions are applied, like you have to assume two roots a and b, fa into fb less than 0, then the new root equal to AFB minus BFA divided by B minus A. So all these formulas are of the previous two methods. Today you will learn about Newton-Raphson method, which is known as Newton's method, which is the simplest and the fastest approach to find the root of the equation. It is also known as Newton's method, and it is very useful when the derivative of the function is very large. This is the formula. You can see new formula, new root equal to old root minus function of old root divided by derivative of the function of the old root. So derivative is here applied here. So derivative will be large, f dash will be very large, and fx sign will be small, then only you will be getting closer to your approximate root value. This is also known as Newton's method for finding roots. So this is a recursive algorithm, and because of it is a set of steps are repeated with the previous answer. Each repetition undergoes a quite number of steps, which is known as iteration. And generally, it is used for complicated function. This iterative process undergoes a guideline to approximate one root. So here we have taken fx equal to x square minus 4. Simply by setting the function to 0, if fx you put equal to 0, then x square minus 4 equal to 0. Any function you can take, you can find root over 11, you can find root over 29, not only root over cube root, fourth root, fifth root, any function you can take yourself and find the approximate value by applying Newton's formula. Also, first you can test and verify yourself by calculator. This calculator is applied here. By using calculator, you can find the root of the function, and you can compare by manually calculating, formulating this process. Then you can see whether your answer is correct or not. So Newton-Raphson method uses an iterative process, and this is the formula again, and these are the steps. Xn is your x value, fxn known as the function of xn, f dash xn is known as derivative of the slope of xn. So delta x known as fx by f dash x, which is known as the dx differential value, and this is approximately closer to zero, then only you can stop the process. That means you have reached your answer. So to see how this works, we'll perform the Newton-Raphson method on the function that we investigated, fx equal to x square minus 4. So fx equal to x square minus 4, then f dash x will be 2x. Let us assume x0 equal to 6. If you assume x0 equal to 6, then fx will be 6 square minus 4, that is 36 minus 4, that is 32. Then f dash x will be 2x. 2x equal to 2 into 6 equal to 12. There, this is the table that we have calculated to find the approximate x value, the root value, the required root value, the answer. So first step, you have assumed x0 equal to 6. Fxn, you are putting x0 value in fx, fx0 equal to 32. Then f dash xn, that equal to 2x. So 2x0, that is equal to 2 into 6, that equal to 12. Then you are getting, after applying the formula, x1 equal to x0 minus fx0 divided by f dash x0. This formula is applied and you are getting x1 equals to 3.33. Now, the next step, you go ahead, the second iteration. Now your x is 3.33. Find out fx by putting x equal to 3.33. Then find out f dash x by putting x equal to 3.33. Then you find the new root x2, that equal to x1 minus fx1 by f dash x1. So x2 you are getting 2.27. Now your x2 2.27 is your x value for the second iteration. Then fx2 will be 1.15. f dash x2 will be 4.54 after you apply the formula 2x. Now the new value x3 equal to 2.01. Then the next iteration, the x value will be 2.01. fx means fx3 you are getting 0.04 and f dash x3 you are getting 4.02. Then the new root will be x4 equals to x3 minus fx3 by f dash x3. So we are getting 2.00. Now see, the difference here in the last iteration is 0.01. Before that, prior to that, the difference was 0.26, which is quite large. Before that, the difference was quite large, 1.06. It was much larger. So once we go ahead in the third iteration, we see the difference is very less, 0.01. Now you compare x3 equals to 2.01, x4 equal to 2.00. So the difference is very less. And after decimal point, 0.01, 0.00. So up to two decimals, you are getting the answer. You can now find that the approximate root value of fx equal to x square minus 4 equal to 2. So this is a very simple problem. I have taken the example to understand the Newton-Raphson method application. So you can apply any method and you can apply any problem so that you can verify the answer, how many iteration it is going, and whether you are getting the answer, the same answer after you apply the formula to the same problem, like bisection formula you can apply, then regular falsi formula you can apply. Then you can apply Newton-Raphson method and see the results in how many iteration in bisection method you are getting the answer, how many iterations in regular falsi method you are getting the answer, in how many methods in Newton-Raphson method you are getting the answer. So if you have to pick a different initial x value, then may we find the same root or may we find the other one, x equal to minus 2. Graphically also, you can represent the whole problem. So it is very helpful to represent graphically. In the first iteration, the red line is a tangent to the curve, and the slope of the tangent is the derivative at the of the function. So another way of considering to find the root of the tangent line, the new x value will be the, like you can see that x0 equal to 6 we have assumed, and the blue line is the function. In x-axis we have taken x value, y-axis we have taken fx value. So how we are getting closure to 2, x equal to 2, and that is the function fx covers the blue line. So this is about Newton's method, and after fourth iteration you have got the answer value of x. You can test any fx like root over 11 and root over 13, root over 15, and how you assume x, that is also most important thing. So then you can get the answer. So this is all about your Newton-Raphson method.